The Lucitone HIPA denture base is a self-curing denture base material. It's designed for use in fabrication, repair, rebasing or relining of full and partial dentures, including implant overdentures or other dental appliances. This tutorial demonstrates the 6 steps involved in the pouring process for fabrication of full and partial dentures. Let's get started. Step 1 is the preparation of the hydrocolloid silicone investment and sprueing. First, incorporate a slight taper into the base of the cast to facilitate removal from the mold material. Incorporate the taper so that the base is the widest. Next, soak the denture wax up on the stone cast to hydrate the model to prevent porosity. Soak for 10 to 20 minutes prior to pouring the mold material. For the mold material, you may use Polyflex, a reversible hydrocolloid or silicone product like Degiform or Silflex. Follow the manufacturer's instructions for preparation and use of the selected hydrocolloid or silicone product and flask. Place wax up in flask. Fill flask with hydrocolloid. To cool and solidify the Polyflex, place flask in water bath for 40 minutes. After 40 minutes, remove flask from water and deflask. Then remove master model and wax up from the Polyflex. Finally, bore sprue holes in the hydrocolloid or silicone mold. Sprue diameter should be large enough to reduce the tendency for air to be entrapped. For example, make the diameter 7 to 8 millimeters where possible. It's important to note that when fabricating partials, each acrylic area must have 2 sprues to avoid trapped air. The second step in the pouring process is wax elimination and separator application. First, clean teeth with the use of a tooth cage and clean boiling water. Be careful to make sure that all wax is removed from the teeth. Next, boil off the wax with clean boiling water. Immediately after boil out, place the cast in a bowl of water for 10 minutes to eliminate air. If there is any air inside the cast, small bubbles may occur in the denture. If needed, extend the soaking time until the cast is bubble-free. Add mechanical retention to the teeth. Remove only enough tooth material to enhance retention. Using a number 4 round, burr cut diatorix in teeth as shown. Excessive removal of tooth material will weaken the tooth and may lead to fracture. Remove the cast from the water and allow it to dry for 1 to 2 minutes. Next, proceed to the second part of this step, applying the separator. Use a brush to apply a thin coat of all-coat separating agent to the cast. Do not allow the separator to puddle. Apply a second layer as needed. Make sure the separator is completely dry before placing it back in the mold. If it is not completely dry, blanching may occur. Use air to blow out the hydrocolloid mold until it is completely dry. Place prepared teeth into the mold. Use a small amount of cyanoacrylate, such as Aran Alpha, on the incisal edge of the tooth to help secure the teeth from moving. Place the cast back into the hydrocolloid or silicone mold. Make sure the cast is seated properly. And when ready to pour the acrylic, the mold should not be warm. If desired, place a plastic sheet over the base of the model to ensure that the acrylic will not leak when it's being poured. Finally, reassemble the flask. Be especially careful to avoid possible tooth and/or cast movement. The third step is to mix the powder and liquid. For the fabrication of one full denture, Use one large scoop, or 20 grams, of HIPA pore acrylic powder and 15 milliliters of HIPA pore acrylic liquid measured with the HIPA liquid vial. For the fabrication of a partial denture, use one small scoop, or 11 grams, of HIPA pore acrylic powder and 8 milliliters of HIPA pore acrylic liquid measured with the HIPA liquid vial. After measuring the liquid, invert the vial on a paper towel to allow residual liquid to drain. Finally, add the powder to the liquid and mix thoroughly for a minimum of 15 seconds to completely wet out the powder. Mix well so as to avoid white areas or spots in the denture. Also, be careful to avoid trapping any air bubbles. The fourth step is pouring the acrylic into the mold. Pour acrylic into mold, pouring into sprue hole on one side only. The pour time should be about 3 minutes at 23 degrees Celsius or 73 degrees Fahrenheit. Step 5 is curing. First, using an accurate thermometer, check the water temperature in the pressure pot and adjust to 45 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree Celsius, or 113 degrees Fahrenheit plus or minus 2 degrees Fahrenheit. Next, place the flask in the water with sprue holes upright. The water level should be below sprue height, but above 2/3 the height of the flask. Be careful. Do not fully submerge the flask all the way into the water. Immediately close the pressure pot and apply 20 psi or 1.4 bars or greater pressure. Do not delay in applying pressure as that may introduce porosity. Cure for 30 minutes. Finally, cool flask and remove denture from the mold. The final step is finishing and polishing. Finish and polish the denture using the normal procedures.